want to take this opportunity to welcome each and every one of you and our online church members, our online worshipers. We want to acknowledge your presence also. And we say, may the Almighty God reveal himself to you this morning as you sit and listen to his word. Amen. Obadiah, chapter 1, verse 15 to 18. I'm reading from NIV. This morning, I want to minister unto you a topic that I've entitled Divine Intervention. Divine intervention. Obadiah, chapter 1, verse 15 to 18. The day of the Lord is near for all nations. As you have done, it will be done to you. Your deeds will return upon your own head. Just as you drank on my holy hill, so all the nations would drink continually. They would drink and drink and be as if they had never been. But on Mount Zion, but in Faithway Baptist Church, but upon my Zion, but in the presence of the living God, there will be deliverance. There will be holiness. And Jacob and Pastor Sam. And Jacob and Pastor Benna who possess his inheritance. Am I speaking to somebody this morning? Do you have people here who are about to possess their inheritance? Jacob will be a fire, and Joseph a flame. Esau will be a stubble, and they will set him on fire and destroy him. There will be no more survivors from Esau. The Lord has spoken. I love the conclusion part of it. He said, the Lord has spoken. It wasn't any man, not any human being, not anybody, but the Lord has spoken. For the Lord has spoken. Let me take you back a little bit. Today we are going to pray. I feel the presence of God so strong here this morning that after the worship, I couldn't. I have to go back to my office and continue. I just went there and knelt down. Oh, boy. Oh boy, oh boy, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord.
You are worthy, Lord.
You are worthy, Lord.
Adonai. You are worthy, Lord.
You are worthy.
you are.
This morning we call you worthy, Lord.
And you are worthy, Lord.
There is none like you, Lord.
That
you are worthy. Alpha and Omega, God.
And you are worthy.
You are worthy, Lord.
You are worthy.
Papa, you are worthy, Lord.
And you are worthy.
Of men. This morning, my prayer is that whatever situation you are going through, God will intervene. I don't know how bad, how rough, how worse that situation is, but may God intervene in that situation. May He intervene in that situation.
Amen.
He has done it before. I am a Kadaya. I don't know why. This morning is different. This morning is different. God help me. This is a story of the Israelites. Bible says that they went through series of invasion 4 times. It was during one of those invasions that the Edomites, they were the descendants of Esau. The Edomites were the descendants of Esau. And Bible teaches us that when the enemies came against the Israelites, they also supported them. And God raised a prophet called Obadiah. That chapter has only 21 verses. It has only one chapter, the shortest of all the Bible. So this man, God put his word in his mouth to prophesy against the descendant of Esau that when the enemies came against my people, you did not do anything about it. You know, sometimes you expect that when you are going through some situations and circumstances, there are some people you expect that they will be there for you. I am Ayakada. You expect that this one I can trust and depend on him. Because this one is my brother. This one is my blood. This one is a true Christian. A preacher, a pastor, a prophet, an apostle. This one, I can count on him. Oh boy. The worship took me very far. When we were going to school, It was a rough moment and a rough season. It was a time the only thing you do is to lay down and cry unto God that Father intervene in that situation. Because if you don't intervene, hunger will kill us. That's why I love this song. Never failed me yet.
Never failed me yet. Jesus Christ has never failed me yet. That's what he has never failed.
That come at a time in your life. You said, this is my body. This one, I can depend on you. Curse be unto one who trusts in man. That's the word of God. Pastor, that come at a time. You know that this one is my own. That's where you feel true disappointment in life, frustrations in life, doubt in life. But may God Himself deliver you from that situation. May you never depend on people, but depend on Christ. He's the solid rock. The Israelites were expecting that Edomites, the brother of Jacob, will come to their aid. The Bible says that when the enemy came, they were just standing aloof. Means unconcerned. Means they did not care. They were hot, standing aloof. And sometimes they also participated in the invasion. You see, in my country, they have this saying that I will not beat you, but if somebody is beating you, I will not come and rescue you. I will not beat you. But if somebody is beating you, I will just stand and watch. You see, we have some people in life. Sometimes when you are going through it, you think that they are there. But at the back, they will just be talking. Say, it's God who is paying him or her back. They call it Nyamine Triawaka. It's God who is Bible says that God put his word upon Obadiah. He said, go and speak to Edomites that upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. Upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. In this church this morning, there's going to be a deliverance. In this church this morning, there's going to be a liberation. In this church this morning, there's going to be a rescue mission. I am on a mission this morning. I said to speak into somebody's life that God is about to deliver you from whatever situation you find yourself. That God is about to deliver you, I said, from that circumstance. And all those who are laughing at you, I said, they will look at you one day today, I am here to announce unto somebody that your condition is never your conclusion. They can never use it against you. I say your condition can never be your conclusion. Where people put full stop, I say, on your life, that's where God begin a new sentence. That's where God begin a new statement. That's where God begin to write, I say, your future and your destiny. Your tomorrow is brighter, I said, than what you are saying right now. I came to announce unto somebody, upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. Deliverance will come one day. After deliverance will come one day. Deliverance will come one day. We used to cry when you were doing worship. I went all the way back those days. Pastor, couldn't hold myself. Hey, we've suffered all. A God who can deliver. The God of deliverance. The God of deliverance. I am here to announce unto somebody, we are not serving a dead God. We are not serving a dead God. We are serving a living God. David said, and this poor man, this poor boy cried unto God, and God heard his prayer, and God came into his rescue. There's a God. Truly, there's a God. But I was talking to somebody, and he's in this country, and you know, sometimes when they are back home, they will pray. When they come here, it becomes a different story. And I was telling him, I said, do I look like a stupid man? I said, do I look like somebody who doesn't know what he's doing in life? Do you think that I am stupid, I am crazy, to the extent that every Sunday I will just carry my Bible and come to church? That I'm stupid, that I don't know how to sleep, that I wake up middle of the night and pray for hours? I have common sense. But I know that this God that we are serving, he's a rare God. That this God that we are serving, he's a true God. I can testify with my life that God is real. That God is real. I said, I'm not wasting my time in vain. I have tried, tested this God. That at the point when you think that it is over, that's where God will step in and say, my son, I am rescuing you. I said, from that, this God is a true God. We are not stupid. We are not crazy people. And we are not ignorant. We know that Jesus came, and we can testify he died. On the third day, he resurrected again. And he is seated at the right hand side of the Father. And he's interceding, I said, for me and you. He's interceding. One day, we will go and be with him. We believe that. We are not practicing religion. I am Akataya. Christ is real. Zion, there shall be deliverance. You see, when God intervenes, he will deliver you. Pastor, it doesn't matter how bad the situation is, he will deliver you. I don't know if I've said this story over here. I went to hospital one time, did all the blood work, they finished everything, and when I got home, they called me that we think that we diagnose you with this. I'm not going to mention it. No, you be afraid. I said, Chai. I said, what did you say? He said, yeah, in your blood, we think that you have this and that and that and that. I was young. I look at my wife. I look at the children. I said, I shall not die. But I will live to declare the goodness of the Lord. And I said, whose report should I believe? Should I believe the report of this person? Or should I believe the report of the God who created me? I am a Kadesh Abad, the God who can infuse me, I said, with the blood, and every sickness, disease in my body can disappear. Whose report should I believe? I believe the report of Jesus. I believe the report of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I believe the report because he said, I shall not die, but I will live to declare. My assignment on this earth is not done. It's not done. I said, I believe that report was a mistake. It doesn't reflect my DNA. It doesn't. He said, it's your blood. I said, no. You made a mistake, Mama. I said, you made a mistake. We have to do it again. I challenged them on the phone. And the lady said, are you okay? I said, you have no idea. The person that you are talking to. I said, we have to do it again. I am coming to that clinic and you are going to take my blood again and you are going to do it again. I went back. I said, here I am. Take my blood again. He took the blood. I went back home. They did it. They called me. And I said, truly, it was a mistake. I am a katayava. He said, but first, we thought that you have this, but now it came negative. I said, what are you talking about? I am serving Jesus Christ, who is able to heal all kinds of diseases and sicknesses. When God intervenes, deliverance will appear. When Jesus intervenes, deliverance will appear. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be. Can I get people in the church who will scream that upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance? Can I hear your voice one more time? Upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. Somebody clap unto Jehovah. It was a wrong report. No. I'm not going to let you go before I talk. I'm not going to sit in my room and cry before I called you. Immediately, I am going to let you know that you've made a mistake. You've made a mistake. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. What Obadiah was telling the Edomites, he said, if you don't help the children of Israel, help will come from somewhere. He said, you are standing there unconcerned. You are standing aloof. You don't care about what is going on with the people of Israel. But if you don't do anything about it, help will come from somewhere. I came to preach to somebody that if they don't want to help you, I am here to announce unto you that help will come from somewhere. I said, if they are sitting down and they said they will watch you, I said, to be disgraced in life, to be humiliated in life, I am here to announce unto somebody that help is coming from somewhere. If they said that you cannot go far, we cannot do it, I am here to announce unto you, help. Help! 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 Mordecai looked at Esther according to Esther 4:14-16. He said, Esther, if you don't help us at this time, relief and deliverance will come from somewhere. I am here to announce unto somebody in your situation, your circumstance. I said, relief is coming from somewhere. I said, deliverance is coming from somewhere. I said, relief is coming from somewhere. I said, deliverance is coming from somewhere. I don't know who called. I said, send me here this morning. I said, to prophesy over, I said, to speak unto, but I'm here, I'm loaded. I said, to announce unto you that help will come from somewhere. Help will come from somewhere. Help will come from somewhere. Deliverance will come from somewhere. Forget about the Edomite. Forget about the Esau. For God is sending somebody into your life. Help! Help will come from somewhere. Help. God will connect you to somebody who will just hold your hand like a baby and help you out. Last time I was sharing our story with one guy, and I told him that, you see, love God with all your heart, with all your mind, and with all your soul. And God, in a mysterious way, will connect you to somebody who will help you. I told him, I said, you know what I do? And everything that I have in that kind of business, God connected me to a certain man who helped me out. He took me as his son. Help will come from somewhere. Today, by the grace of God, I have DR to my name because God connected me to Dr. Pierre. Help. If, brother, they say they are not going to help you, just depend on God for help. For help. From help. From help. Aye. Help will come from somewhere. Ladies and gentlemen, in this life, depend on God. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. There shall be restoration. There shall be holiness. And the Jacob, I always put my name over there. I delete that name and I put my name. That Pastor Edward who possess his possession. You see, when God delivers you, now he takes you to another level. I call it the recovery stage. You see, there's going to be a recovery of everything that the enemy has taken out from you. You see, recovery leads to what? Restoration. And restoration leads to the possession of your possession. My God, I don't know who I came to announce unto this morning. I don't know what you've lost in life. But here is the season. Today is the season that God is going to cause you, I said, to recover everything that you've lost. Everything that the enemy has plundered you. Everything that the enemy has stolen from you. Everything and anything, I said, that you've lost in life. There is going to be a recovery. There is going to be a restoration. And there's going to be a possession. It looks like your life is delayed, but I'm here to announce unto you that delay is not a denial. You are about to enter the realm of recovery. As God spoke unto David, he said, David pursued the people. I said, David, surely you will overtake them. And David, surely when you overtake them, you shall recover all. You shall recover. You shall recover your glory. You shall recover your riches. You shall recover everything. I said that you've lost in life. I am here to announce unto somebody that recovery is coming. That restoration is now. 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 That restoration restoration is now. You've been disappointed for long. You've been looked down upon for long. You've been written off for long. You've been crying for long. But today is your season. Today is your moment. I say of recovery, of recovery, of recovery. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be holiness. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be recovery. People are going to recover. I said, their possession, years of struggle, years of struggle, years of pain, years of struggle, years of pain, years of struggle, years of pain, years of loss. You are about to enter into the realm of recovery. If you are the one I'm speaking to, can I hear your voice in the house? Can I hear believers out? I say, in Faithway Baptist Church, can I hear believers? I say, in Faithway, I said this morning, because recovery is now, I say restoration, I say it's now, you are overtaking, I say you are overtaking, I say you are overtaking, I say you are overtaking, it's a prophecy unto somebody, it's a prophecy unto somebody, it's a prophecy unto somebody. I see God moving you, I say from the back seat into the front seat. I see God taking you, I say from the back seat into the front seat. The struggle is over, the pain is over, the tears are over, the cries are over, the cries are over, the cries are over. For upon Mount Zion, I say upon Faithway Baptist Church, I say this morning, deliverance is now, deliverance is now, recovery is now, restoration is now. It is your moment, it is your moment, it is your moment, it is your moment of restitution. Let me hear believers in the church. My God, upon Mount Zion. Last time I was saying it's a miracle at Mount Zion. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. Daddy, they will deliver them. God said, I will deliver you from the Babylonians. I will deliver you from the Egyptians. I will deliver you. That when I deliver you, whatever they took from you, I, God, I will replace them. It's going to be a restitution. Somebody clap for Jesus. You know, I don't like using restoration a lot. Because restoration is, if I lost this handkerchief, then I will get the same handkerchief. If I lost this Bible, it means that, Mama, I will just get this Bible as a replacement. That is to restore back onto your former position. But with restitution, that one, it comes with multiplication. It is not addition, but it is all. Ah, my God. My God, my God. So if I lost $50,000, God is bringing me $200,000. If I lost just one house, God is bringing me, I say, everything a double, double. Somebody made the Lord Almighty, I say, give you more than enough. May the overflow of abundance, I say, be your portion this morning. An overflow, an overflow, an overflow, I say, be your portion. May God just not only give you what the enemy took from you. May God just not only give you, I say, what you lost years ago. May he give you, I say, more than enough. Somebody shout, more than enough. I say, more than enough. I said more than enough. I said more than enough. I said more than enough. Come on, let me hear your voice in the house. If the woman, the man who left you was a millionaire, may God give you a billionaire. No, if you marry the same person, that you will say that we are all hot. Co-equal, we are equal. But may God give you somebody who is better as I am. Am I preaching to somebody this month? Am I prophesying over somebody's heart? I said, what you lost, I said, may God give you. I said, greater, I said, than what you have lost. I said, years ago, may God give you. I said, better. If I lost 2016 car, may God give me 2023. The one when you speak, the car will spark. My God, the one when you sound, the car will turn. Am I speaking to believers? I say in Faithway this morning, may God give you more than enough. If you are the one I'm speaking to, let me hear your voice in the heart. Restoration is now. I don't need the same thing. I want more. Shout more. Shout more. Shout more. Shout more. More anointing. More glory. More power. More unction. Everything doubled. Everything doubled. Everything doubled. Everything doubled. Everything doubled. In the name of Jesus. Let me hear believers in the house. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. There shall be restoration. And upon Mount Zion, God will intervene and fight your battles for you. God will intervene and fight your battles for you. Pastor, upon Mount Zion, because God cannot just deliver them without fighting for them. How am I going to be? Can you enter a strong man's house? Unless you do what? You defeat that strong man. Unless you bind that strong man. So God cannot just deliver the people without fighting for them. It is impossible for me, I said, to deliver you unless I liberate you or I break the power that is holding you. Are you getting it? So God said, go and prophesy unto Edom that I, God, I will come down and I will fight for my people. God sent me here to announce unto somebody that the battle that you are fighting, he said, for the battle is not your battle, but the battle is unto the Lord. For I, God, I will fight that battle as for you. For I, God, he said, you've been fighting it on your own for quite a long time. He said, leave it for me and I will fight it for you. If you are the one I'm speaking to, let me hear your voice. You've been fighting that battle, I said, on your own. Are you not tired? Are you not stressed out? Are you not frustrated? He said, I am coming down this morning, for upon Mount Zion, there's going to be a war. That God, he said, Jacob will be a fire, and Joseph will be a flame, and Esau will be a wood. That fire will be fire, which means that God said, I am going. Oh God, this morning, you see, you've already won the battle. Let me announce unto you, I said, the battle is over. I said, the fight is over. Let me just announce unto somebody, I said, the fight is over. I said, the fight is over. I said, the fight is over. I said, the battle is over. I said, the fight is over. For Jehovah is fighting. I said, that battle right now, heaven has been activated. The Supreme Court of Heaven has been activated. I said, the angels of heaven have been activated, and they are fighting your battle. I said, for you right now, I said, the fight is. Battle is over. It's over. And because that fight is over, He said, when I deliver you, when I restore you, when I fight for you, then I will give you peace. I will give you all peace. Pastor, when God intervened and delivered the people, because at that time they had no peace. It doesn't matter how much money you have on this earth. If you don't have peace, you cannot enjoy it. It doesn't matter how beautiful, how handsome the house you live in, the car you ride. If you don't have peace, you cannot enjoy it. And he said, I am going to deliver my people. I am going to restore my people. I am going to fight their battle for them. And when all these things are over, I, God, I am going to give them the peace of mind, the rest that they need in life, the rest that they need in their marriage, the rest they need in ministry, the rest they need at their workplace, the rest they need. I, God, I am going to grant them that peace. Can somebody help me to sing this song? Then when peace like a river, Mama, help me.
When peace like sea.
Can I say that it is well? Am I allowed, Mama, to speak into your life that it is well? Am I allowed to speak unto somebody's life?
With my soul.